Hello friends, I'm Dr. Sonu Yadav and today's topic of discussion is examination of PBF, that is peripheral blood film. This lecture is an overview of how to report PBF, that is peripheral blood film. Peripheral blood film, it is mirror to the bone marrow status, the functional status of the bone marrow. It provide rapid, reliable access to information about a variety of hematological disorders. It is inexpensive but a powerful diagnostic tool. It offers a window into the functional status of the bone marrow. And review of the smear in addition to clinical data sometimes give enough information to establish a diagnosis. So it is of very much importance. Now what are the indications? These are the some indications of peripheral blood film. Evaluation of anemia. Identification of any abnormal cell. Evaluation of thrombocytopenia and thrombocytosis. Infections like malaria and microfilaria. Inclusions. These are the various indications for examining PBF, that is peripheral blood film. Now, this is the diagram showing an unstained PBF. This is the labeled area of a slide in which a unique ID is given. And this is the feathered edge. It should be monolayered. And this is the body of the blood film. Now basically a PBF is, normal PBF is tongue shaped and it has various parts, that is head, body and tail. These are the three parts of a normal PBF, peripheral blood film. This is the stained picture of a PBF. Stained slide. Stained with Leishman stain. Now this is the zone of morphology, the area which we have to examine and give the reporting. The zone of examination, it should neither be head end nor tail. It just the junction between body and tail. Now these are the various slides. The first one showing the unstained PBF, then it is the stained ideal thinly prepared blood smear, and these two are the slide, these two smears, this is the thin film and this is the thick film. Both are inappropriate for reporting. This is the stained thin blood smear which is ideal for reporting. Now these are the slides which are inappropriate for reporting. As you can see, these slides contain various bubbles in between the staining, and this is not tongue shaped, and in this also the PBF is not made properly. So we have to report PBF on an ideal film. This is the PBF slide and this is the zone of examination, that is the junction between body and tail. So this is the area of examination, the junction between body and tail, where the RBCs just touches each other, whereas on the head end there is roulet formation, and on towards the tail end there is sparse density of the blood components, as you can see. So this is the appropriate area of examination, where the RBCs just touches each other, and this is the best area to be examined for reporting. These are the slides again showing the area of examination. This is the head end दिस इज टूवर्ड्स द टेल एंड एंड दिस इज द अप्रोप्रिएट एरिया दैट इज जंक्शन बिटवीन बॉडी एंड टेल वेयर द आर बी सी इज जस्ट टचेस ईच अदर. इट इज द बेस्ट एरिया टू बी एग्जामिन्ड. Now these are the PBF which shows the first one the stain is too acidic. This is the normal stain PBF and in this the stain is too basic. So you can get this type of picture if the stain is too basic and this kind of picture towards a pinkish when the stain is too acidic. Which will lead to inappropriate reporting. So how to correct these errors? If the slide is the PBF is too acidic, what are the possible causes? There will be prolonged buffering or prolonged washing which leads to too acidic stain. If you have used an old stain or if there is an insufficient staining time. All these three factors lead to too acidic staining. Now what are the corrections? Lengthen staining time, increase the staining time, shorten buffering or wash time and check the stain and buffer pH. Now if the PBF is too basic, then what are the possible causes? Thick blood smear, prolonged staining, insufficient washing, alkaline pH of stain components. Now what are the corrections? Check the pH, shorten stain time and prolong buffering time. So these are the few corrections so that you can avoid too basic staining. Now coming on to the examination part. How to examine a PBF. So we have to start with the 10x. On 10x we'll observe the distribution of cells and select the appropriate area for the examination for reporting and we'll see if there is any roule formation, agglutination, see the platelets, any parasite. Now at 40x we'll see the morphology in detail of all the three blood components, that is RBC, WBC and platelet. On 100x we'll see the RBC, WBC and platelet morphology again and confirm the morphology if we have any doubt at 40x. And we also observe any RBC inclusions and hemoparasite. So always start examining the slide at 10x. Now these are the points you have to mention in PBF reporting. First of all, when you get the slide peripheral blood film, you have to make general assessment of the CBC parameters. You will correlate the parameters with the given slide. Then you have to do the DLC. Then RBC morphology, WBC morphology and platelet morphology. We have to see the morphology of all the three blood components, that is RBC, WBC and platelet, and see if there is any deviation from the normal and then we have to report accordingly. And we also have to note if there is any other defect. So these are the points which should be included in a peripheral blood film reporting. The various factors are general assessment of the CBC parameters, RBC morphology, WBC morphology, platelet morphology and other defects. Under WBC morphology, you have to do the TLC and DLC. टोटल ल्यूकोसाइट काउंट एंड डिफरेंशियल ल्यूकोसाइट काउंट. नाउ कमिंग ऑन टू द डीएलसी, डिफरेंशियल ल्यूकोसाइट काउंट. इट इज डन यूजिंग अ जिगजैग मेथड ऑन द स्लाइड. वी हैव टू काउंट 100 वाइट ब्लड सेल्स एंड दे विल बी एक्सप्रेस्ड एज परसेंटेज. सपोज दिस इज द जोन ऑफ मोर्फोलॉजी, देन यू विल गो इन अ zigzag manner to count the 100 WBCs using a cell counter, and then you'll give the percentage for each type of WBCs, that is न्यूट्रोफिल, बेसोफिल, इओसिनोफिल, मोनोसाइट एंड लिम्फोसाइट. वी हैव टू गिव देयर परसेंटेज एंड सी इफ देयर इज एनी डेविएशन फ्रॉम द नॉर्मल और नॉट. देन वी विल असेस द सीबीसी पैरामीटर्स विद द स्लाइड. These are the normal values of various parameters included in the CBC: hemoglobin, PCV, RBC, RBC indices, MCV, MCH, MCHC, and RDW. And this is the differential leukocyte count. This is the absolute value of neutrophil, lymphocyte, monocyte. And this is the platelets. So we have to correlate the CBC with the slide given. Then we have to see the morphology of all the three components one by one. So coming on to the RBC morphology, we have to comment on shape. Any variation as compared to normal. And variation in shape is known as poikilocytosis. This is the term used when there is any variation in the shape of RBC, that is red blood cell. So we have to comment in a PBF that poikilocytosis is present or absent in the given slide. Now then we have to comment upon the size. And variation in size is known as anisocytosis. So if this is present in a given slide, then we have to mention the positive finding that anisocytosis is present in the given PBF. First of all, we'll comment upon shape, then we'll comment upon size, and then we'll see the color. And based on color, they can be differentiated as hypochromic red blood cell, hyperchromic, and normochromic. If the central pallor is greater than 1/3, it is regarded as hypochromic, and if it is approximately 1/3, then normochromic, and if it is less than 1/3, then hyperchromic. Then we'll see and comment upon any inclusion in the RBC, for example basophilic, stippling, Hinge bodies, etc. And they'll comment upon any nucleated RBC present or absent. We have to always mention the positive findings. If they are present, then we have to report in a PBF. So on RBC morphology, these are the various points which we have to mention. First of all, we'll tell about the shape, size, color, inclusion, and nucleated RBC. Then WBC morphology, will tell about the total leukocyte count and then we'll compare it to the CBC report. Then we'll do the DLC and comment if there is any immature white blood cell present or absent. Then we'll see the platelets, we'll count the platelet and match it with the CBC report if there is any deviation or not. Then we'll see any abnormality in the platelet, for example giant platelets. Then we'll comment upon parasite, present or absent. If present, we'll name the parasite. For example, malaria. If it is present, then we'll also report the species for better treatment. So these all are the points which will include in a normal peripheral blood film reporting. So what are the points? First of all, we'll start with RBC, then we'll comment upon WBC, platelets, then any parasite, hemoparasite. First of all, we'll get the CBC report along with a slide. Then we'll start examining the slide at 10x. Then we'll go to 40x and 100x. So we'll start with RBC. We have to comment on any variation in shape and size. If this is present, then start with N-isopoikilocytosis present. And then we'll comment upon the population of the RBC. Predominantly, the RBCs are normocytic, normochromic, microcytic, hypochromic, or macrocytic. Then we'll report accordingly. Then we have to comment if there is any nucleated RBC present or not. And then we'll say about inclusions. Then we'll coming on to the WBC morphology. First of all, we'll check the TLC, then we'll do the DLC, and then we'll report if any abnormal or immature WBC is seen or not. Then we'll count the platelet and match it with the given CBC report, and we'll report if any abnormality in the platelet is C. Then we have to report regarding parasite, present or absent, and then we have to identify the parasite. If it is not seen, not present, then you have to simply write no hemoparasite seen in the studied smear. Now, for example, this is a CBC report of a patient, and after studying the CBC report, these are the findings: hemoglobin decreased, RBC decreased as compared to normal, all the three RBC indices, that is MCV, MCH, MCHC, decreased as compared to normal, RDW increased. So these are the findings which we have concluded after studying the CBC report. Now we'll go to the slide. So this is the slide. So first of all, we'll assess the parameters given in CBC report. As it is given in CBC report, the hemoglobin is decreased and RBC is decreased. So we can clearly see the RBCs are decreased. They are less in density as compared to normal, and they are hemoglobin is decreased. So you can see their central pallor is greater than 1/3, as all the three indices are reduced. So MCV is reduced. You can clearly observe the central pallor is greater than 1/3. So they all are hypochromic. Now these are the small dot like, these are platelets, and these are the various white blood cell. So how to report? You'll start with RBCs, and as you can clearly see, you have to report shape, size, then population, nucleated RBC, inclusions. Just keep these points in mind and report accordingly. So we'll start. As you can see, these RBCs are of various size and shape. This is somewhat elliptical, this is round, this is small, this is large, they are of, and this is pencil shape, elongated. So there is variation in shape and size of RBC, as you can see. So we'll report starts as N isopoikilocytosis present, and then you have to comment upon the population. RBCs are predominantly microcytic hypochromic. As you can see, the microcytic, we have to compare it with the size of nucleus, and you can clearly see all these RBCs are smaller as compared to nucleus of the lymphocyte. So they are termed as microcytic, and they are termed as hypochromic because the central pallor is greater than 1/3. So RBCs are predominantly microcytic hypochromic. Now in this field, there is no nucleated RBC, so the negative finding no need to mention, just skip this. And there is no inclusion in this field, so no need to mention about inclusions. But you have to see before final reporting, you have to see thoroughly see many fields before reporting. This is just an example. So N isopoikilocytosis present, RBCs are predominantly microcytic hypochromic, no nucleated RBC seen. Now WBCs, you have to give the TLC, then DLC, and then you have to mention any abnormal cells seen or not, then platelet count, any abnormality. We'll study all the three components in detail in coming lectures. So this is how you will report a peripheral blood film, RBC, WBC, platelet and parasite. If present, you will write the hemoparasite seen and you have to mention the name. If the parasite is absent, then you'll say no hemoparasite seen in studded smear. This is your PBF reporting. Now these are the examples of various PBF. So this is the first one. It also shows a microcytic hypochromic picture, as you can see. And this is the second PBF. It shows nucleated RBC. So if they are present, then you have to mention it in your report. In this picture, you can clearly see there is variation in shape and size of RBC, and these are the various shapes, as you can see, teardrop. This is target cell. This is also target cell, elliptocyte, target cell. So you have to mention if there is poikilocytosis present or not, and if it is present, then mention the type of shape. It is spherocyte, elliptocyte, stomatocyte, target cell. And this is the slide showing polychromasia. Polychromasia is multicolor RBC, somewhat bluish, shade of blue. So as you can see, this slide is having polychromasia. So you have to mention it in your report. Again, you can see nucleated RBCs. These are the platelets. Now this is the PBF showing polychromasia and nucleated RBCs. So this is an overview how to report and examine a peripheral blood film.